Man, that bat looks bossy.
Whatever.
Looks like you shoot distorted sonic waves.
How's this? Let's hit it up! Hurry! Try this out! Keep it on! Return to force! Ready?
Go!
Doing. He's yet inexperienced.
Sure hope this is edible.
You used to live on this mountain, Edna?
Yeah. It's a nest for man-eating monsters nowadays, though.
You didn't have to say that much.
It's just a fact. Even he doesn't recognize me anymore.
What brilliance!
It's got such an intimidating aura!
Yes, it's dangerous to go near it without heed. Especially when they cast curse spells. Ready? What a pain.
Yeah.
bridge looks better than ever. But that just means...
Alicia!
Saray, what are you doing here? And the others?
Of course.
Shame you can't see us, though.
Isn't that natural?
Hey! Rose, wasn't it? You were with the Sparrow Feathers who came to the palace.
Nice to finally meet you in person, Princess Alicia.
Just Alicia will do.
Rose is helping me out big time.
As Squire?
Don't worry, she's doing a great job.
I see. I'm sure it helps that you've grown into your power. But still, Rose must be incredibly special.
That's the nicest thing I've ever heard.
Well, you and Saray are so alike.
That's not the nicest thing I've ever heard.
Very true. My apologies.
Hey, what are you apologizing for?
Saray, I'm glad you three are getting along, but we came here on a mission.
Oh, right. There's something I want to ask you, Alicia.
Shrines of Trials.
Ring a bell?
I'm not sure if it's what you're looking for, but just the other day we received word of a ruin discovered at Lake Haven Heights. It's a military secret, so I don't know the exact location, but the entrance is supposedly extremely well hidden. Lady Maltran has just gone off to investigate.
Maltran?
The discovery came about while apprehending a group of thieves. They turned out to have several famous swords in their possession. The military decided that further investigation might turn up something useful to them.
Something useful for the war?
Yes.
Lady Alicia! The captain is awaiting your report!
Apologies. I'll be right there. Sorry, but I've got a job to do. Please, come back to Lady Lake again sometime. I shall pray that you overcome your trial safely.
Thanks. See you again.
Understood. I shall report as such to my superiors.
It's just as you can see. They sent me out to inspect the bridge.
Jerks.
Hey.
It's okay. Lady Maltran is helping me out a great deal, and I can still keep going.
You sure about all this?
Rose?
I'm sorry. I shouldn't have said that.
No. You're probably right. No matter how I protest, I don't think the war can be stopped. I want to just drop everything and run, all the time. But whenever my thoughts drift in that direction, I stop. The strength of a knight exists to protect, and their kindness serves the people. Those are the words I learned from my teacher.
Guess you have your honor too, Alicia.
Oh, not really. I'm just obstinate.
So, you're just like Mikleo then?
Is that supposed to be a compliment?
Sure, laugh at my expense.
All right. And with that, I must be off. Be well, everyone.
You too!
Later! Something tells me Alicia actually wishes she could go with us, deep down.
Huh?
Just a vibe I got. Hey, Alicia used to be your squire, right? Why did she leave?
Well, I wouldn't say she left. She just had her own goals and...
I think she did want to go with us, but her resonance just wasn't quite up to snuff.
The backlash was damaging Saray.
He was losing his sight.
Oh dear. So that's why... Wait a minute, what about now? You're not hiding anything from me, are you?
Not at all! I swear!
Your resonance is powerful enough to enact armatization. It's right on par with the Shepherd's.
Is it really? I guess I'd better be grateful for my resonance.
Grateful, huh?
Here.
Probably don't need to.
I guess something like this is right.
Thank you.
Hmm?
Tell me we were gonna fight my brother. I'm not gonna help you.
Hop away! Let's get out of here!
What are they?
Phantom Hellions. Ones who are trapped by malevolence even in death.
Wind Blade!
Wind!
Put some thought into it.
Wind Blade!
Whirlwind!
Flash!
Strike!
Dragon Blitz!
Go!
Shred!
Throw a charge!
Too close!
Dragon
Blitz!
Ha!
Wind Blade!
Dragon
Blitz!
Feel my heart!
Gale Bang!
Whirlwind Slash! Here goes!
Strike!
Dragon Blitz!
Feel my
wings!
Flickering Bang!
Strike!
Dragon Blitz!
Feel my wings!
All together!
Despair
Pilot Protect! Whirlwind Attack!
Come forth!
Get up, Space Eagles!
Kick it close!
Feel my wings!
Strike!
Or escape Dark Star!
Feel my wings!
Do you feel it?
Soul weapon!
Wow, what a cool weapon! Think I could use it too? Lila, what did you mean they were trapped by malevolence even in death?
Humans and seraphim, in fact all living species, have something within their bodies called a soul. A phantom is the hellion which results when that soul itself is corrupted by malevolence.
Then does that mean, even if we purify them, they won't go back to their human form?
Yes. They are already dead. But if we don't purify them, their souls will retain their malevolence, drifting around aimlessly for all eternity.
As Hellions who continue to prey on humans, you mean?
So purification is still a way to save them, right?
It is.
Okay. I know what I must do.
The entrance to the ruin's supposed to be really well hidden, right?
We better be extra diligent in our search. Alicia's cleared of suspicion, right?
You mean the suspicion that she was communicating secretly with the Roland's Empire?
Yeah. I heard that she got arrested for that.
It was probably just a false accusation to lure you into war.
Yeah, and we kept our promise. They have no reason to keep her detained.
I hope you're right.
But the situation is different than before.
Huh?
I'd imagine so. There was that clash with the Roland's Empire, you know?
So if she'd seek peace with them in this situation...
It would only make things worse for her.
Too bad she's not the type to just sit patiently in times like this.
Alicia is part of the royal family. The Chancellor shouldn't be able to do anything so brazen.
I sure hope so. Way stronger than the ones we saw when we left the village.
This is a manic armor. It is said that they're strongest when the full moon is out.
Then now's our chance. We can take them on.
Rising sand! Echo shot! Rock mirror! Morning fly! Rock mirror! Here goes! Rising sand!
Purification complete!
Thank you.
Whoa! We're in Gramps' domain!
Gramps' domain is pretty strong.
Indeed. You're there, aren't you? Mushrooms! Are they safe to eat?
The ones closest to you are okay, but stay away from the ones in the back.
You got it!
Wow, how do you know all that?
It's just common knowledge.
This forest, it's so rich and abundant with life.
Yeah, that's the power of Gramps' blessed domain.
Oh, so it's Gramps' domain that makes it feel this way?
It's a sizable amount of power. Even among high-ranking seraphim, there are very few on his level.
That's Gramps for you. Anyone comes by who's up to no good, they get zapped in the butt with lightning. Pow!
He can wield lightning?
Yep, he lights up the sky like fireworks.
I sure remember fireworks when it came to him and you.
Well, figuratively.
Oh, and that explains all the mushrooms.
Huh?
Oh, right! Where Monday's lightning strikes the ground, Tuesday's mushrooms will be found.
Aha! So we have Saray to thank for this harvest.
Hey! No, it wasn't like that.
Unbelievable.
What's wrong?
Shh, it's nothing. Keep still.
Whoa, check out that beetle!
Be quiet! Don't you know what that is?
What is it?
An around-eyed stag beetle.
Is that good?
It's incredibly rare. Atlas beetles die within a year, but stag beetles can survive the winter months with a typical lifespan of 3 years. This one in particular has remarkable tolerance to cold. It can be packed in snow on all sides and still not freeze to death. Some have been known to last for over a decade. They were thought to have gone extinct 100 years ago or so. I've only heard them whispered in legend before today.
Whoa, neat! The Phantom Beetle!
Understand? So be quiet.
Right. Don't want it to get away.
It already did, while Dezel was blabbing on and on about it.
It what?
Not that I can blame it.
Thank you.
I wonder if Gramps is here. How are you?
You stupid brats!
Whoa, what's this all about?
Don't you have something to say to me first? I don't remember raising a fool!
I'm sorry for leaving without telling you.
It's good to be home.
Nice to meet you. My name is Rose.
Well, in any case, I'm glad to see you're safe. The Lady Squire is welcome here as well.
You can tell that I'm a squire?
Of course I can. Saray became the shepherd, and Mikleo is now a sublord, correct? Which would mean that the Prime Lord is the Lady of the Lake, then.
It has been a long time, Sir Zenris.
You don't have to say anything. History repeats itself. It makes the world go round.
True, but I still want to believe in them. And believe that they can bring forth a new future.
Well, I'm glad you've all found such a nice Prime Lord. Hey, by the way, did my pipe come in handy?
Oh, yeah.
Don't worry about the pipe. As long as it was useful to you.
But I'll give it back. I don't need it anymore.
Keep it for yourself.
Really? I'm okay. You know, I've grown up a lot through this journey.
Bratty as ever, aren't you? Please, take this with you.
Thanks, Gramps.
No. I should be the one thanking you.
Saray, why don't we take a little break here?
Are you tired?
No, but it's a good idea to take a solid break to rejuvenate the soul.
Totes, let's do it.
Sure, I did want to chat with everyone in Alicia too.
All right, we'll meet up later.
I sure hope this is edible. I wonder where Mikleo and Lila went. What are you doing, Mikleo?
Shh.
I see. Just as I thought, they...
Come on. Wait.
I'm so sorry. I wasn't aware of it and made the pact.
No. It was of their own decision that they made the pact with you. What they make of it will be up to them.
I'll support them with all I have, so that we won't repeat the same mistake.
Don't be so hard on yourself. There was nothing you could do for the previous shepherd.
Perhaps, but sometimes I can't help but wonder. Surely I could have done more than I did back then.
Everything is tied to their fate, and their fates are yet intertwined.
Yes, thanks to you, Sir Zenris.
No, you and those kids forged that bond. My role in this is done. All I can do now is worry about them.
There are times when things go awry, but their purity and virtue gives me hope. I want to accompany them on their journey. This time, there will be no regrets.
I see. Perhaps this is also how humans and seraphim should coexist as a whole.
I'm glad I was able to talk to you.
And I with you. Please, take care of him.
Weren't they just talking about us?
Looks like it.
Why don't we ask?
Mick Leo.
I guess we shouldn't eavesdrop on their conversation.
If Gramps has something to tell us, he'll tell us straight up.
Yeah, same with Lila.
Lila, how did you know Gramps?
Is Zenris his real name?
Yep. No one calls him that in Elysia, though.
I've met him before. Just once.
Weren't you guys having some sort of serious conversation? What was that?
A cheeky chimp chucked cheap chocolate chips in the cheap chocolate chip shop!
This again?
Since when did you know that Saray and Mikleo were the old man's family?
Red leather, blue leather, yellow leather. Red leather, blue leather, yellow leather!
Come on, just tell us.
I don't need to know. Gramps wouldn't do anything to harm us, I'm sure.
But if we did something wrong, there'd be no telling how much hell we'd catch.
So you trust him?
Yep, as much as I trust Lila.
That's a whole bunch of Norman we found.
Yes, an abnormal amount.
But I gotta say, their abilities really are helpful. Why does everyone leave them alone?
Yeah, you'd think there would be droves of Seraphim asking for their help.
Long ago, there was in fact an enormous demand for them. They were booked up for months at a time.
So why are they just wandering around now?
One day their leader, well, their leader-ish person, rose up against the extreme work conditions. Demanding autonomy for Norman Seraphim, plus a significant raise in wages. He called on the other Norman to join the fight for independence.
A Norman revolt?
Were there many casualties?
None. The only one pushing for independence was the leaderish fellow. The others were simply like...
We don't mind helping, but it'd be real sweet if we could get maybe a 300-year break between crunch time.
And that was more or less that.
So easygoing. But that's Norman for you.
And what happened to the leader?
Well, that's a whole nother...
After a protracted battle with another Seraph, he lost and was never seen again. Or so the story goes.
Huh. So Norman have their own history too.
Lila, I get. But you sure know a lot about Norman, Edna. You really must like them a whole...
I just hear rumors, that's all. Lila, sit here for a second.
What is it?
Just take a seat. So, you'll have a lot of Norman acquaintances, but don't seem terribly interested in Norman.
Well, I mean, we're just friends is all.
What the? Just sit down already. Lila, you're underestimating them. Remember, we need to catch 50 of them or else.
You really like the Norman, don't you, Edna? You even got one on your umbrella.
You kidding me? I totally don't like them. Now, why won't you sit down?
The last time I sat down, it was to pull an all-nighter. That's bad for fair skin like mine, so good night.
Hey, sit down.
You! Give up! We caught you red-handed!
Darn!
That voice...
It's a Hellion!
Purify him.
Yeah!
You need something, oh great shepherd?
Is it all right if I deal with this boy?
I'm afraid not. The only way to apprehend pickpockets is to catch them in the act.
But he's...
If you do the crime, you do the time. No matter how old you are.
This kid just wasn't ready for real-world consequences.
Hey, mister! Why don't you let Saray have a talk with him before you take him away? Just a word from the shepherd might steer the kid toward the right path in life, better than any time in detention.
That would be pointless.
Come on, it won't do any harm. What, you got some problem with Saray talking to this boy?
I never said that. It would simply be a waste of time.
You said this kid wasn't prepared to deal with the real-world consequences of his crimes. Are you prepared, mister?
What?
I'm part of a merchant crew that travels all over the world. You think I don't know why the pickpocketing problem is so bad?
I see. How much do you want?
Don't put me on your level. We Sparrow Feathers value our customers' trust. Saray, we're taking this guy to jail, too.
Like hell you are, you lying brat!
You will not lay a finger on her.
Shepard!
Oh, hey, stop! Wait! Saray!
Go after him.
Okay.
If it ain't one thing.
Saray, I'll go after them as well.
Please purify that boy.
Shepard or not, I won't let you obstruct my duties! Guard, leave him alone! Even we can tell something about you stinks!
Yeah, what kind of guard are you?
You think we don't know what you're up to when our backs are turned? You dirty crook!
I think we're good here. Let's go after Rose.
Yeah, you're right.
We're heading after Rose, right?
Phew!
You made it.
Is it over?
Maybe.
If it really bugs you that much, why don't you check up on him?
Well, how would we do that?
Let him lead us home.
Oh, so he wanders and we tail him.
That could work.
All right then. Saray, Rose, you guys hide. I'll go wake him up.
Looks like they've made their decision. Are you okay with this, Lila? Well, as long as we only follow him.
Now!
Yeah! Don't you think he'll stop pickpocketing now? We purified him after all.
Not so sure about that. I've heard word of pickpocket gangs.
Oh, really?
We need to find out whether he was doing it on his own or with a group.
What do you mean by you knew why the pickpocketing problem is so bad?
The enforcers let him off a lot of the time in exchange for part of the takings. Then, When the guards need to hit their quotas, they round them up anyway. That's probably what that was about.
No way!
Look, he's going in.
A noble's manor.
It's clearly not his house.
I'm guessing a pickpocket gang, then.
And so this must be their base.
Something tells me he's not gonna quit stealing.
Well, crap. Come on, we're not done yet.
Rose, it's unfortunate, but I'm not sure we should...
Lila means that this is just a problem of human society.
Right. It might not be something a shepherd should get involved in.
Huh.
Sorry. If he's doing it by himself, I'd be okay letting him deal with the consequences. But if there's a gang forcing him to steal, it's a completely different story. I gotta check to make sure.
Yeah, I thought so. I understand. Let's go check it out just in case.
You sure?
But no more than that. Understood? Saray, Rose, even if you don't intend them to, the powers of the Shepherd and the Squire can greatly influence human society and the spirits of men. Please don't forget that.
All right.
We'll just watch and see who goes in and out.
Bored.
Who knew that we wouldn't see anything for days on end?
You all can go back to the inn. I'm staying here.
It's okay.
Shh, someone's coming out.
It's a bunch of little kids.
Those kids? You think maybe they're not being forced to pickpocket?
We've come this far. Let's see this thing through.
Dezzle?
You go follow those brats. I'll go check out the building.
Thanks.
Oh boy.
Don't go for anything big, got it? Only money and jewelry and stuff.
Are they gonna have anything like that?
That shepherd guy did something, and now there's lots more people donating stuff to the sanctuary.
Oh cool, that sounds fun. Priests won't be mean to kids, and if there's any real problems, we can always start crying. I'm good at that.
Hey! Is this really okay?
It's okay if you're us and not them.
Is this what kids are like these days?
Dangerous times.
Those kids barely have any malevolence at all.
Children in their brutal honesty can be even crueler than corrupted adults, as you've seen.
Oh, Dezzle! How was it?
The building was completely empty. Those scamps are probably just camping out there.
So then, those kids are acting on their own.
Snatching time!
Now that we know the score, do we want to report them to the guards and end this whole thing? After all, they're not Hellions. Let's tell the guards about it, and then put it all behind us.
Okay.
I can't do that!
Hey, Rose!
Darn it! What do you want? Look, I never did nothing!
We know all about what you're up to. Fooling the priests into thinking you're helpless orphans and then robbing them blind. You should be ashamed of yourselves.
Oh yeah? You got any proof?
This here is the shepherd. His word is good enough.
That's perjury! False witness!
Princess Alicia and the people of Lady Lake all trust Saray. Because he's been living an honest life. How about you? Will anyone trust your word? Give it up, kid.
What else can we do? The adults all abandoned us. If we want to survive, stealing's our only choice.
Rose, maybe we ought to...
Come on, Saray. Let's bring them to the guards.
But to think children their age could conceive of such wretched duplicity.
And the other children?
They were all caught by the guards and hauled away.
I see.
Those who commit crimes must be punished, even if they are children. It's the way the world works. But it still pains the heart.
Yeah. Hey, isn't this an Earth in Historia?
Oh, that. That was a donation from someone in the city. It looks rather rare and precious, so we've been unsure whether we should sell it.
Nice! Good call, Mr. Priestman!
Huh? Oh, thank you.
Father Brunor, we're actually collecting these.
You think we could have this? We'd pay for it, of course.
No, please, that's not necessary. If it's something the shepherd needs on his quest, by all means, please take it. I'm sure the donor would be overjoyed to know that their gift had been some help to the shepherd.
Thank you, Father Brunor. Wow! I never knew there were once so many shepherds, all using their purification powers on Hellions!
So the question is, why and how did they disappear?
What do you think?
If the existence of so many shepherds depended on Maltellus, then...
When Maltellus disappeared, so did all of them.
Isn't it too early to jump to conclusions?
Well, what other possibilities are there?
Maybe humans abandoned their faith in Seraphim to the extent that shepherds just ceased to exist.
Perhaps the large crowd of shepherds we saw was just a historical anomaly.
Maybe only people like Saray can be shepherds, and there's just fewer nice guys in the world these days.
Huh. So there's plenty of other possibilities.
I guess that means we have to keep collecting information.
Yes. If you do that, you will surely arrive at your answer.
Thanks, everyone. I needed that.
You're okay with how it worked out?
It's better than ignoring it and spending the rest of your life wondering.
Yeah.
Bunch of hopeless delinquents. Those street kids in Lady Lake.
Well, if society's abandoned them, I don't know. Is there any other way for them to survive besides a life of crime?
It is a sad era we live in.
Give me a break. If you have to do wrong to trudge onward, you do so knowing the burden of that wrong. You hide that dark shadow within yourself and keep pressing on. Those kids weren't like that. They just went astray.
Hey, don't look at me when you say that!
Rose, so those are the things you have to think about, huh?
I don't think, I just do! Ugh, let's stop talking about this.
You mean you're just spontaneous? That's... awesome.
Yes. No matter the circumstances, it's up to each person to decide how she wants to live her life, and for what she must be held accountable.
But Rose understands that instinctively, without thinking. Very impressive.
Seriously, can we change the subject?
Maybe the experience of abandonment will get those kids to realize the importance of responsibility. Thanks to you guys pointing them in the right direction.
I hope so.
Yeah.
If it were that easy, the Age of Chaos would be over already.
Hello. Is Alicia here?
Shouldn't you announce yourself? Or don't you have any respect for this family?
I'm sorry. My name is Saray.
Saray? Pardon my rudeness. The princess has spoken highly of you. She's out right now. We're not sure when she'll be back.
Work-related?
Yes. She's going after a suspect who's leaked information to the Roland's Empire. There definitely must be a spy going around, given the timing of their advancements.
Yes, even Alicia was under suspicion for it before.
Wow, the Princess of Hyland would go so far as to do that herself?
No, it's supposed to be the military's job, but she's acting by herself. Saying that she had to stop a clash between the two countries.
But isn't she taking it a bit too seriously?
Ever since the Battle of Glaven, she's been pushing herself so hard.
That's very like her.
I'm worried. She behaves so recklessly when she's alone. She just headed out to a round-eyed forest to gather info about the origin village, Camlon.
Huh. Camlon, you say?
It's the village where the Age of Chaos started, I think. But it's just some legend.
Yes! She heard a rumor there were some clues in the depths of a round-eyed forest and headed out there.
So that's how she came to Alicia.
But her hunch was wrong. I've never heard of this origin village from Gramps nor the other villagers.
Yeah, I guess that's true. I'll take my leave. Please tell Alicia that I'll come visit again.
She's pushing herself as a princess.
Alicia's always been like that.
That's exactly why I'm worried.
Is this acceptable?
Hey, you there. Take this to the inn.
You! This is all your damn fault!
Hurry up, kid!
All the grown-ups do is order us around, day in and day out. You call this saving us? Some shepherd you are. Screw you!
Looks like they've turned to honest labor now.
Yeah, but it didn't make us popular, that's for sure.
That's fine, as long as they're keeping out of trouble.
Saray.
Don't move. You are under arrest for leaking confidential info.
Looks like Alicia came to the same conclusion.
What is the meaning of this?
I'm sorry. This is just a misunderstanding. Please take your leave, Princess. This is...
Don't make excuses. I found evidence of connections to Rowlands in this very residence. Renovations for Grifflet Bridge, order forms of military arsenal, unauthorized transactions for...
That is simply a reward for his support.
Support?
Logos is an important person who connected Rowlands and Hyland through unofficial diplomacy.
What does that mean?
On the surface, diplomacy between Hyland and Rowlands has been cut. He must have been negotiating with them on his own for some time in secret.
So then he's not a spy, but a liaison.
Meaning even with the war going on, there's been work done.
Such is politics.
This is a major problem. If the channel gets blocked, both countries will fight until they're both obliterated.
But no one ever told me anything about it.
Of course they didn't. Not to someone like you. I hope you're prepared to pay for your indiscretion.
In any case, we must change our strategy. We will be expecting your sincere apology at a later date.
Understood.
Killer, Lila. You were in perfect harmony.
He was quite skilled, despite his youth.
Yeah. Compared to him.
You've still got a long way to go.
Lila, I wish I could go on a journey like that with you.
Saray. Excuse you, Saray.
Huh?
Yes. This journey now is every bit as enjoyable as it was back then. Thanks to everyone here.
I wonder what happened to Alicia.
Let's go to her house.
Thank you.
Saray, wait!
How did it go?
Fortunately, we were able to prevent rumors from spreading. Though in the end, I did have to prostrate myself.
That must have been hard.
Don't worry, it's fine. I did go a bit too far after all. The Difta family has been surviving as a branch of the Imperial family. But my mother was born to normal citizens, and was later courted on a whim by my father. So everyone forgave me and assumed it was natural I didn't follow politics.
M'lady!
And so... that's why I wanted to do the right thing! I wanted to gain acceptance from everyone in honor of my late father and mother. Was I wrong in the end?
I shall go fetch some more tea.
Let's leave her alone just for a moment.
Right.
What a pain.
Being a princess sure sounds rough.
Nations and politics are like an entwined spiderweb full of people's desires. If you are too full of ideals, you'll be entangled in the web instantly.
But still, I don't want to say that Alicia's completely wrong.
Especially since we know the reason why she's been working so hard.
In times like these, Alicia's straightforwardness is a truly valuable asset. However, a sword that is too hard can break easily.
True. And besides, Alicia does make sound arguments.
Isn't that a good thing?
It's like, you know how if someone pointed out your wrongdoings, it really hits you? You'd probably get discouraged, or even snap.
They're only human, after all.
Meaning that by pushing her sharp reasoning on others, it causes cognitive dissonance and turns people against her. So that's it.
Even though she's right, she's met with hostility. And she faces her challengers straight on. Which in turn only brings forth even more hostility.
So that's why she worries so.
What a pain.
I'm sure it's tough on her.
However, I don't think Alicia's feelings are completely misguided. Though we may need to assess the situation to know for sure.
Alicia isn't the only one. I need to see for myself as well.